Friends, in this session, we are going to solve some questions and we'll discuss our approach and thinking as and when we see question, how we recognize the topic and how to begin with. All those things will be discussed while solving. So let's start as if we are appearing for some test. The question is, are these points collinear? Three points are given in terms of coordinates. That means it's a question of coordinate geometry. But we'll discuss about the topic later. For now, just assume that any three points or just three dots are there on a paper, naming A, B and C. And suppose AB is 3 units and BC is 5 units. Can you tell me which three points are in a straight line, that is collinear? For that, let's join all three points. When we join these points, it should make a straight line. At only one place, we are getting a straight line because at this point, distance between A and C is equal to the addition of the distances between AB and BC. At rest of the places, it would make a triangle. Since AB is 3 units and BC is 5 units, then AC must be 8 units in order to be in a straight line, or else AC will always be less than 8 units and forms a triangle. Now we'll find the distances between coordinate points and check whether it forms a straight line or not. So here we proceed. The given part is 3 points. So let's name them. Now these points are P, Q and R. And we have to see whether points are collinear or not. So this is the tool which will help us to find the distances between the coordinate points. Friends, you can write this in such manners as well. Order of x1, x2 and y1, y2 doesn't matter. Because when we square a negative or a positive number, it gives us a positive number only. And this is the solution part. The distance between P and Q is 2r, and distance between PR. I found the distances and noticed that addition of these two small numbers is not equal to the remaining bigger one. So I conclude that they are not collinear. Friends, you can see that before starting the solution, we discussed a lot and after that, we solved it quickly, without any mistake. But as we discussed, if points are not collinear, they will form a triangle. So friends, can you tell me what kind of triangle it is? We recognize the types of triangles by looking at their sides, whether all of the sides are equal, only two sides are equal, or all of them are of different lengths. So if all the distances are equal, it's an equilateral triangle. If only two distances are equal, then it's an isosceles triangle. And the third case is, the triangle may be a scalene triangle as well. In our case, all the sides are of different lengths. So it is neither equilateral nor isosceles. That means it's a scalene triangle. Friends, a triangle may be a right angle triangle also. So if we want to check whether our triangle is right angled or not, for that, what must we do? As we hear the name right angle triangle, suddenly Pythagoras theorem pops up in our mind. So square all the values and see if sum of any two small numbers is equal to the remaining bigger one or not. So I found that it's a scalene right angle triangle. See how easy things are. We just need to concentrate a bit and apply a little bit of logic. Alright, let's quickly have a look at this question. Are these points the vertices of a square? Let me tell you the idea behind it. First of all, I'll make an imaginary diagram of a quadrilateral ABCD. Now, if AB, BC, CD and AD are equal, means it's a square, right? So we'll find all the distances. But still, this is not the whole solution. Even if all four distances are equal, we cannot say that it's a square, because it may be a rhombus as well. Now what to do? Another property of square is that its diagonals are also equal. Therefore, with all four sides, we'll also have to find whether diagonals AC and BD are equal or not. Now, this will be the proper solution. You must be thinking, if we directly find AC and BD, the lengths of the diagonals, is it enough to check for a square? The answer is no, because even rectangle and isosceles trapezium also have equal diagonals. So, we need the information of sides along with the diagonals to confirm whether it's a square, rectangle or trapezium. So, to find out whether the given points are collinear, to recognize the different types of triangles, including the right angle triangle, and to determine whether the four given coordinates form a square, we used only one formula, that is the distance formula. Before going, take this question as an exercise and try to solve it. And write your answer in the comment box. Till we meet next time, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.